Hi guys, welcome back here at TEC Engineering Tutorial. So this will be our part 3 of the design of drainage channel. Okay. So balikan lang natin. So last time na-stop tayo dun sa mga type ng slope na. So ngayon puntahan natin yung sa GBF classification. Lampas na ako. Wait lang. Ito. So, dito tayo na-stop last time. And? So, okay na tayo dito. Okay. So, proceed tayo dito sa GBF classification. Okay. So, ganun pa rin. We have this GBF and GVF dito sa drawdown curve natin. So, ngayon, magzo-zoning tayo, no? So, we have the mild slope and the steep slope. Okay? So, we have this zone 1, this layer, and we have this zone 2, itong layer na to, and we have this zone 3, itong layer na yan. Ha? And then, dito naman, we have zone 1, zone 2, and zone 3. Na? So, ngayon, yung GBF na to is, andito siya sa mild slope. M stands for mild. And, bali, yung drawdown curve na to, ito yung GBF, eh, no? Yung drawdown curve na yan. Pasok siya sa zone 2. No? Kaya, tinatawag natin itong M2. No? We classified it as M2. So, bali, dito sa GBF, dito sa steep slope. So, meron tayong S, na? S stands for steep slope. So, bali, yung drawdown curve na to, pasok siya dito sa zone 2 pa rin, no? Kaya, we classify it as S2. So, that's how we classify. Okay, considering this one. So, from steep to mild. Ayan, meron tayong dalawang possibility. Unahin muna natin yung first possibility. Ayan. So, we have this mild slope and steep slope, no? And we do the zoning. We have zone 1, 2, and 3. And then, zone 1, 2, and 3, no? So, bali, yung i-classify lang naman natin dito is itong GBF. So, ito yan, no? So, meaning, andito siya sa steep slope. So, S, no? S for steep. And then, pasok siya sa zone 1, di ba? Ito yung zone 1. Dito siya sa zone 1 na part. Tinatawag natin yung S1, na? Ngayon, dito naman sa second possibility na mangyayari is, ganun pa rin, we have mild and steep slope. We do the zoning 1, 2, and 3. And 1, 2, and 3, na? So, bali, yung GBF, ito yung ika-classify natin. No? Take note, andito tayo sa mild na part. So, we have M for mild. And pasok siya sa zone 3. That's why we call it M3 or we classified it as M3. Okay? So, M3 yung classification natin dyan. Okay, so, we have RBF analysis. So, ito yung RBF analysis considering itong scenario 1. We have this one, na? So, to do that, we have mild and steep. So, we have this different zoning kanina. So, dito sa RBF, meron tayong upstream. Kasi dito nag-start yung, ano, yung flow. Eh. So, ito yung upstream natin. Dito yung downstream natin. No? So, yung meron tayo is itong upstream, no? Which is equal dito sa normal depth, no? Nung water dito sa steep slope. That's why YUS is equal nung YN. Yung di natin alam is itong Y dito sa upstream na, I mean sa downstream na part. No? We call it sequent depth. Pero may formula tayo for that. So, yung formula for that is just this one. No? That is just the negative of the y upstream divided by 2 plus twice nung velocity sa upstream squared yus over gravity plus yus squared over 4. Then yung quantity na to is being raised to 1/2. Okay, so yan yung magiging formula natin to compute for yds or the sequent depth. And yung us stands for upstream, ds stands for downstream. So yung issue natin dito is makompute natin yung length ng hydraulic jump, no? Para alam natin kung hanggang saan lang yung section na itataas natin yung depth ng kanal natin, di ba? So, that would be L. So, that is defined by the formula 220 YUS hyperbolic tangent of the probe number US minus 1 divided by 22. And for this scenario to is, ayan, no? So, di natin alam yung upstream dito, no? Di ba? Di natin alam yan, no? Pero yung alam natin dito is itong downstream na part, no? Kasi inline na yan sa YUN nung mild slope, no? So, anyway, so, yan yung YUS. So, yung YDS is just equal nung YN nung mild. Pero yung YUS or yung sequent depth, masusolve natin yan using this formula. The same lang kanina, yung kaibahan lang is nabaliktad na, no? Kasi yung kanina upstream dito eh, kasi downstream yung kinocompute natin. Ngayon, kung upstream yung kinocompute natin, yung downstream na yung magiging variable niya dito, no? The same formula. Ngayon, yung issue naman is to compute for the length, di ba? So, the same formula kanina. Upstream pa rin yung gagamitin. Okay? Okay. So, ngayon dito sa rapid flow analysis, meron tayong dalawang possibility na mangyayari. Ngayon, yung issue ngayon is saan dito sa dalawa yung mangyayari talaga dito sa section natin, di ba? So, what we yung ginagawa natin is we perform a logic test, no? So, yung logic test natin is first we assume that itong possible scenario 2 would occur, no? Like assume 2 is true. So, ngayon yung gagawin natin is we calculate for YUS dito sa hydraulic jump, di ba? So, ngayon kung yung YUS hydraulic jump natin is dito na part is mas malaki compared dito sa YN ng steep slope, meaning, di ba? Mas malaki siya, meaning increasing yung tubig, no? From the steep to mild, no? Nag-i-increase yung tubig, meaning parang puntang hydraulic jump siya, no? Meaning tama itong 2, no? Kung ganun yung mangyayari, di ba? So, it shall occur at the mild slope, transition from supercritical to subcritical. Otherwise, kung hindi naman, like, pababa siya, di, yung nangyayari pala talaga is itong 1, no? Itong 1 yung nangyayari. Okay? So, kung hindi siya paakyat, we can guarantee that situation 1 is true. Okay. So, ganun lang, no? So, we just perform the logic test. So, we have also GBF analysis. So, like kanina, ayan. So, ayan, no? So, ito yung classification ng GBF natin. So, yung ginagawa pa rin natin is we compute for the length of reach, that is delta L, which is equivalent to the delta E. E stands for specific energy, no? Kung makikita mo naman sa formula, you have this potential energy plus this velocity energy. So, if we sum this up, the potential and kinetic energy, we call it specific energy, no? So, this is just the difference between these two values. And then, divided by SO, yung sa slope natin, minus the friction slope natin average. Okay? So, yung SO can be solved using Manning's formula. So, for English unit and for SI unit, yan, no? Yung kaibahan lang is 1 dito, and dito is 1.486. Yung SF average is, yan yung average, no? Average friction slope at the beginning and end ng steep. For example, if you are considering this GVF M2, so like, kukunin mo yung friction slope dito sa upstream, tsaka kukunin mo yung friction slope dito sa downstream, no? You take their average, yun yung SF average. Okay? So, ganun din yung mangyayari dito sa GVF S2, no? Kukunin mo yung SF dito, kukunin mo yung SF sa upstream and downstream, and you take their average, yun yung SF average mo. That is GVF classification. So, you can perform that as a whole. But usually, sa mga computer software is, yung ginagawa is, gina-divide nila by segment, no? To minimize the energy, no? So, like, you have YN and YC. So, the equation assumes that the change in energy between the start and end of the GVF is minimal. So, kasi maliit lang siya, eh, no? Kaya yung ginagawa to accumulate the energy. No, kasi maliit lang, eh. Sinisegment na lang siya, no? Mas precise pag ganun, no? Mas precise. But, kung manual, so pwede isang section na lang yan, no? Like, buo mo na i-analyze. Anyway, software kasi, no? Like, not a big deal. Software bitong mag-solve, di ba? kaya na yan ni computer kasi yung magsosolve. No? So, kahit ilang segment pa yan, no? Kanya yung i-process. Okay, so we have this different change in L, 1, 2, and 3, and 4. So we have this summation of change in length. So change in L. So for every change in length, we have this different normal depth. We tabulate that one. We have Y, area, hydraulic radius, velocity, energy, change in energy, friction slope, friction average. And we have this difference and change in L, no? Yung length of reach. So, each of the segments corresponds to a specific location in the channel, each separated by a different change in the length calculation. Okay, another parameter we use in the design of channel is itong preboard. Okay, so ngayon, ayun, yun yung tinatawag natin na preboard. Okay? Yan. Yan yung preboard. So, for various shape ng kanal, so for rectangular, ito yung preboard. For trapezoidal, ito yung preboard. Di ba? For circular kanal, ito yung preboard. For triangular kanal, ito yung preboard. So, the flow capacity in the cross-sectional area including the preboard shall be about 1.25 to 1.35 times the design discharge. Diba? Kasi may increase ka pa eh. May preboard ka eh. No? So, may increase din ng design discharge. Diba? For unlined channels, the preboard shall be calculated as follow. So, pag yung depth ng flow mo is 0.3 up to 2 meters. So, yung preboard mo is just 0.4 ng depth. Where FB is the preboard in meters, while D is the depth of flow during the crop maintenance in meter. And pag more than 2 meters, ito yung gagamitin natin. 0.25 depth plus 0.3. And if we take account for the velocity head, HV, that's the velocity head, no? That is equivalent to V squared over 2G. So ito yung mangyayari na formula. 0.05 depth plus HV plus this ranges from 0.05 meter to 0.15 meters. Okay, it's up to the designer na. So, for the NIA, yung established preboard criteria niya is 40% no, of the water depth using a minimum of 0.3 meter. So, meron tayong minimum na preboard na 0.3 meter or sa minimum yan. No? But you can use basta bali, we compute for 1.4 of the depth. Then, yung 1.4 of the depth must be greater than or equal nung 0.3. No? Okay, so we have also this top burn width. Ito yung burn natin. Okay, for flood banks. No? So, yan yung burn. So, the top burn width should be approximately equal to the depth of the canal prism of the canal. Depth of water plus the preboard with a minimum of 0.6 meter. We have also channel bend. No? Yung channel bend is mangyayari ito kung meron tayong channel along the side of our roadway or highways. Di ba? Minsan nag-perform tayo ng super elevation. So, meaning, wala nga naman yung channel mo is straight pa rin. Di ba? So, ganun din. No? It follows the geometry nung road natin. So, meron din tayo dito. At channel depth, the water surface elevation increases at the outside of the bend because of the super elevation of the water surface. So, meaning, yung ano lang man sa atin dito is yung additional preboard. No? Kasi, syempre, di ba? Mag-i-increase yan eh. No? So, dapat may additional preboard tayo for that. So, additional preboard is necessary in bend and can be calculated as follow. So, ito yung formula na ginagamit. Change in D, that is V squared over the top width of the gravity times the radius of curvature of the highway. Okay. Radius of the curvature of the bend of the channel center. Okay. Tama pala, channel pala. So, parang ganyan, ha? So, yung mangyayari is makikita mo yung increasing ng velocity. Nung height ng water. So, parang ganito, no? Okay? So, tangent theta is just b squared over gr. So if you compute for tangent theta, that is equivalent to change in depth over dt, which is equal to b squared over gr. So if we solve for change in depth, so madi-derive natin yung formula kanina ng ganito. Okay, so another parameters we use in the design of channel is itong allowable curvature. So allowable curvature for unlined canals depends on the size or capacity, velocity, soil, and canal section. So yung minimum radius of curvature is from 3 to 7 times the water surface width, the largest ratio for larger capacity, or 15 times nung water depth. So we have this minimum 3 to 7 nung water surface width, and yung maximum is 15 times nung water depth. Ayan, na? So the design of an irrigation channel involves condition of steady and uniform flow. So the same depth of flow and discharge at all sections in a particular reach under consideration. Design of irrigation channel is based on the mean velocity of a flow, which is obtained by standard formula which express the mean velocity of a flow as a function of hydraulic roughness of the channel, hydraulic ridges, and hydraulic gradient. So another parameters that we take account is the canal cross section. Okay? So ilagay ko na lang to sa next na video, no? Kasi marami to eh, no? So aside from canal cross section, under din dito yung most economical sections. Okay? So that would be in the next video. Just keep on watching and keep on learning. See you in the next video. Thank you.